the SR-71 Blackbird was faster than official records show. Here's what they didn't tell you. Imagine having the ultimate sports car parked in your garage, a vehicle so fast that it leaves even the top racers in the dust. Now, replace that car with an aircraft, the SR-71 Blackbird, the fastest jet ever built. Today, we're diving into the story of this incredible machine, an aircraft that was so fast, the Air Force might not have even told us the whole truth about its capabilities. The SR-71, also known as the Blackbird, holds the record for the fastest reusable crewed jet aircraft, officially hitting speeds of Mach 3.2. That's already mind-blowing. Imagine traveling at over 3 times the speed of sound. But what if I told you that this was just the tip of the iceberg? Many pilots and insiders suggest that the Blackbird could go much faster, perhaps even reaching speeds that remain classified to this day. Think of it like this. You've heard rumors about a mythical creature in the forest, and while the official reports give you some details, the whispered stories hint at something much more extraordinary. Today, we're peeling back the layers of secrecy to explore the true potential of the SR-71 Blackbird. Stick with me, because this journey is going to be as thrilling as the aircraft itself. Official records versus pilot accounts. Despite being retired for over 25 years, the SR-71 still holds the crown as the fastest reusable crewed jet aircraft ever, with a recorded top speed of Mach 3.2. That's like driving from New York to Los Angeles in just under an hour. But here's where things get interesting. Several former Blackbird pilots have hinted that this plane could actually go even faster. It's like talking to a race car driver who hints they've gone beyond the speedometer's max reading. They won't spill all the beans officially, but the stories they share are pretty eye-opening. Imagine being at a party, and someone starts telling you about a legendary athlete who, during practice, breaks records that no one else knows about. That's what it's like listening to these pilots. They recall moments where the SR-71 seemed to push the limits far beyond what's documented. For instance, one pilot mentioned a time when their Blackbird was cruising so fast that it felt like they were leaving everything behind in a blur. While none of these pilots would go on record with exact numbers, their stories all point to one thing. The SR-71 had a hidden potential that was never fully revealed to the public. Let's break down some of these accounts and data. Official records are like the tip of the iceberg. We see the impressive stats, but beneath the surface, there's so much more. The Air Force might have wanted to keep these extra capabilities under wraps for strategic reasons, but the pilots' anecdotes give us a glimpse of what the Blackbird was truly capable of. These tales of the SR-71 pushing beyond Mach 3.2 are not just about speed, but about a machine that was designed to operate at the very edge of what was technically possible. The official limits. According to the US Air Force, the SR-71's top speed is Mach 3.2. Pilots were strictly advised not to push past Mach 3.3 because of concerns about thermal and structural integrity. Think of it like driving a supercar that the manufacturer says shouldn't go over 200 miles per hour, even though you know it might handle a bit more. Former SR-71 pilot Brad B.C. Thomas shared that most pilots typically hit around Mach 3.33 during their standard missions. That's like going 100 mphes faster than the official limit, which is pretty wild when you think about it. Imagine you're driving a high-performance car on a racetrack. The manufacturer tells you the car can safely reach 200 miles per hour, but experienced drivers know it can push to 210 miles per hour without any issues. It's thrilling, but also nerve-wracking, because you're flirting with the car's absolute limits. That's what SR-71 pilots experienced. They were flying one of the most advanced aircraft ever built, aware that they were pushing boundaries, but confident in the plane's capability to handle just a little bit more speed than officially acknowledged. Now, why did the Air Force set these conservative limits? It's like when a chef perfects a recipe, but advises diners to stick to a certain amount of spice. The chef knows the dish can handle more, but wants to ensure everyone has a safe and enjoyable meal. Similarly, the Air Force wanted to make sure their pilots and planes stayed safe during missions. By setting the limit at Mach 3.2, they provided a buffer against potential risks. However, the fact that pilots like Thomas regularly flew slightly faster suggests the SR-71 was built to handle more than it was officially credited for. This blend of caution and capability adds another layer to the mystique of the Blackbird, highlighting its incredible engineering and the trust pilots had in this remarkable aircraft, pushing the limits. But what about during testing? This is where things get really exciting. Retired U.S. Air Force Master Sergeant Jim Goodall's book, Lockheed's SR-71 Blackbird, reveals some jaw-dropping details. Imagine taking your supercar out on a closed track with no speed limits and seeing just how fast it can really go. That's what the engineers and test pilots did with the SR-71. In one test flight, Blackbird tail number 974 hit an astonishing Mach 3.43. That's over 175, much faster than the official top speed. And believe it or not, that's not even the highest speed ever recorded for this plane. Think of it like an athlete in training who breaks their personal record behind closed doors. They might not announce it to the world, but in that moment, they know they've achieved something extraordinary. That's exactly what happened during these SR-71 test flights. These weren't everyday missions, but controlled scenarios where pilots could push the Blackbird to its absolute limits. Hitting Mach 3.43 shows just how much potential was built into the SR-71, far beyond what was publicly acknowledged. And here's where it gets even more fascinating. There are whispers and unconfirmed reports of the SR-71 hitting speeds even higher than Mach 3.43. It's like hearing about a legendary sports figure who, in their prime, pulled off feats that seemed impossible. These stories, while not officially documented, come from credible sources who were close to the action. They hint at a reality where the SR-71 was not just the fastest jet on paper, but a true marvel of engineering that could push the envelope in ways we're only beginning to understand. Brian Schul's account. Let's dive into one of the most thrilling accounts from the SR-71's history. Former pilot Brian Schul, a legend in the aviation world, claimed that during Operation El Dorado Canyon in 1986, he pushed the SR-71 to Mach 3.5. Imagine that, Mach 3.5. That's like driving your car at 230 mph faster than its highest speedometer reading. Schul's story is that while outrunning Libyan surface-to-air missiles, he had no choice but to push the Blackbird to its extreme limits. Now, some folks debate Schul's tales, saying they might be a bit exaggerated. But here's the kicker. Tim Yarrow, a research analyst from Lockheed Skunk, the very team that built the SR-71, believed Schul's account. It's like having the creator of a roller coaster confirm that yes, it really can handle that insane drop you just heard about. When someone from the team that designed and built the aircraft backs up the story, it adds a whole new level of credibility. So, what does Mach 3.5 mean in the world of the SR-71? It's not just a number. It's a testament to the incredible engineering and daring spirit that defined the Blackbird. Imagine being in Schul's shoes, flying at such a blistering speed that even the fastest missiles couldn't catch you. This isn't just a story of speed, but of survival, and the lengths pilots would go to complete their mission safely. Pushing the SR-71 to Mach 3.5 was about more than just numbers. It was about harnessing the full power of one of the most advanced aircraft ever built, showing just how far ahead of its time the Blackbird truly was. The A-12's record. Now let's take a step back and talk about the SR-71's older sibling, the A-12. This aircraft was the precursor to the Blackbird, and it has its own set of impressive stories. In Jim Goodall's, he recounts a test flight where pilot Jim Eastham pushed the A-12 to a mind-blowing Mach 356 during a dive. Just picture that for a moment. Mach 356? That's over 275 mph faster than the SR-71's official top speed. It's like hearing that an older model of a car can actually outperform the latest version in some ways. Despite this incredible feat, the A-12 doesn't hold the official speed record. It's similar to how some musicians might be incredibly talented, but never get the same recognition as more famous artists. The A-12 was every bit as impressive, if not more so in certain aspects, but it often gets overshadowed by the more well-known SR-71. Eastham's flight is a clear example of the A-12's raw power and capabilities, pushing the boundaries of what was thought possible at the time. So, why doesn't the A-12 hold the official speed record? It's partly due to the fact that the SR-71 was the one that saw more action and public attention. Think of it like a blockbuster movie that gets all the hype. Even though an earlier film might have set the stage for its success, the A-12 laid the groundwork and proved that these extreme speeds were achievable, paving the way for the SR-71 to take the spotlight. Eastham's incredible flight reminds us that the A-12 was a trailblazer in its own right, capable of speeds that still boggle the mind today. Setting records. Setting an official speed record is no small feat. It's not just about going as fast as you can for a moment, it involves a lot more precision and official verification. The National Aeronautic Association, NAAA, has strict requirements for these records. They need you to cover at least 200 kilometers, which is about 125 miles, with certified equipment and observers to make sure everything is legit. This isn't like a quick dash on a back road. It's more like running a marathon, where every step is closely monitored. The A-12, despite its incredible capabilities, officially clocked in at Mach 329 back in 1965. That's still blisteringly fast. But it wasn't the absolute peak of what this aircraft could do. The SR-71, on the other hand, set its official record at Mach 332 in 1976. It's kind of like the difference between two athletes where one edges out the other by a fraction of a second in an official race. Even though both are incredibly fast, these official numbers give us a glimpse of the extraordinary engineering behind these planes. But remember, these records are based on controlled conditions and verified flights. It's like having an official lap time on a racetrack versus those legendary stories of what a car can do off the record. The A-12 and SR-71 both showed they could push past these official speeds under the right conditions, hinting at a potential that goes beyond the numbers we see in the record books. So while Mach 329 and Mach 332 are the recorded speeds, the real capabilities of these aircraft are part of the fascinating and somewhat mysterious legacy they've left behind, beyond the records. So how fast was the SR-71, really? This is where things get really intriguing. Officially, we know the Blackbird could hit Mach 3.2, and some test flights even reached Mach 3.3. But many sources, including stories from the pilots themselves, suggest it could go as fast as Mach 3.5. Imagine driving a car that's rated for 200 meters per hour, but knowing it could actually handle 220 meters per hour if you pushed it. Exceeding Mach 3.3 with the SR-71, however, was pushing the plane right up to its thermal and structural limits, where things could get risky. Former Skunk Works director Ben Rich, a key figure in developing the SR-71, noted that the plane was designed to cruise comfortably at Mach 3.24. Pilots who flew the Blackbird confirmed that at Mach 3.2, they still had some throttle left, like having a bit more gas pedal you could press down on. But given the SR-71's enormous cost, about $334 million in today's money, pilots were cautious. They knew the plane was capable of more, but they didn't take unnecessary risks. It's like owning a luxury sports car. You know it can go faster, but you're not going to push it to the brink unless absolutely necessary. This combination of official limits and the pilot's own experiences paints a picture of an aircraft that was incredibly advanced, even beyond what was publicly acknowledged. The SR-71 wasn't just fast. It was a marvel of engineering designed to operate at the very edge of what was possible at the time. Its ability to cruise comfortably at Mach 3.2 and still have room for more speed tells us that the Blackbird was built with a lot of untapped potential, hinting at capabilities that were far ahead of its time. Final thoughts. As we wrap up our journey through the incredible world of the SR-71 Blackbird, one thing remains abundantly clear. This aircraft was much faster than the Air Force officially admitted. With records of speeds reaching as high as Mach 356 during testing, it's hard not to wonder about the Blackbird's true capabilities. Imagine if you found out your favorite athlete had been holding back their fastest times all along. It's that kind of revelation. We may never have all the answers about just how fast the SR-71 could truly go. The secrecy surrounding its performance was part of its mystique and strategic advantage. Yet, the stories from pilots, the documented test flights, and the whispers of even higher speeds achieved under controlled conditions paint a picture of a plane that pushed the boundaries of what was technologically possible. The SR-71 wasn't just a marvel of speed, it represented the pinnacle of Cold War-era aviation technology. Its ability to fly faster and higher than any other aircraft of its time remains a testament to human ingenuity and the relentless pursuit of innovation. The Blackbird's legacy lives on not just in its speed records, but in the stories of the brave pilots who flew it and the engineers who designed it. So, the next time you hear about an aircraft claiming to reach incredible speeds, remember the SR-71 Blackbird, a true icon that soared beyond the limits and left a lasting mark on aviation history. Its true capabilities may still be shrouded in secrecy, but one thing is certain. The SR-71 was, without a doubt, faster than the Air Force will ever fully admit. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for more updates. And to watch the latest geopolitical news, watch this video here.